I'm scared about Mr. Blair and his attitude to the future. I think we're at a watershed moment. September the 11th was the first part of this watershed moment, and this is the tail end of it. September the 11th was so obviously directed at America to provoke a response, and the response was supposed to be revenge. We've spent something close to, what is it now? So something close to 18 months trying to prevent that knee-jerk reaction. And if all it's been is delay, then what was the point?
Well, there wasn't a knee-jerk reaction, was there?
No, there wasn't. But you don't think this is...
There's been a properly considered reaction, consultation around the world, hasn't there?
Has there?
Hasn't there?
I don't see any consultation.
American politicians?
I see a lot of bullying.
Checking around the world?
Yes, but do you see them actually saying anything but terrorists? It's either the terrorists or us.
Your complaint is that there hasn't been a debate, that the newspapers...
No. My complaint was, it was 8 months ago, that there was no debate.
So you've had plenty of debate since then?
Oh, yeah. All of which is being ignored. That's my point. I'm here because I'm
ignored
proud.
Ignored by whom?
By the Prime Minister.
Well, he's seen the need to go out and make the case for what he believes in.
Yes,
that's a response to the debate, isn't it?
Absolutely. And do you not think that his voters have told him they're not convinced by that?
Somehow.
No, 91%
not united.
91% said without the UN, they didn't want to go in. Didn't you think that's close to unanimous?
You were so much aligned with Blair and Cool Britannia, mm-hmm. weren't you?
No, I wasn't. I never turned up at that bloody party. Excuse me. I was never going to be used that way. When I saw Tony Blair, I saw him in Islington before he got into Downing Street, right, when he needed people like me. I saw him personally. I went and had a meal with him, discussed it, because my lawyer is a member of the Labour Party.
But you supported it, didn't you?
When?
Then.
Supported the Cool Britannia. I've never believed in Cool Britannia. No, it's not. You're not talking to Noel Gallagher or somebody from the Britpop age. You're talking to somebody who started 21 years ago. Cool Britannia is a load of bollocks to me. I'll be honest, I've been very distressed by Mr. Blair's behaviour for several years in terms of the way I think he's removed the idealism from politics by taking a supposedly left of centre party and calling it Labour or New Labour, and then basically saying that we have to be pragmatic. The left is really in these overly consumerist times.
He also said you have to have an ethical foreign policy, didn't he?
Absolutely, and absolutely, this is not ethical, is it? This is a Christian country with supposedly a Christian leader who somehow think that the answer to the future is preemptive action. Now, to me, preemptive action is every bit as dangerous a concept as the initial concept of creating the atomic bomb. And by the way, that was created for the same kind of deterrent purposes by the same nation. And I do not believe that this is any more safe than that.
You'd still vote for him?
No, I wouldn't vote for him. I would never vote for him again. Never vote for him again. Because he's gone beyond the bluff. He's now bullying the UN on behalf of
bullying?
Mr.
Persuading,
Bush.
He would say.
I'd say bullying. You have to be... you cannot ignore statements like the UN needs to prove its relevance. You cannot ignore the fact that America could sit there and say, you either agree with us or you're irrelevant.
15 members of the Security Council, mm-hmm. unanimous, signed mm-hmm. up to Resolution 1441,
yeah, and it's
calling
obvious.
On Iraq
Why?
To disarm.
And it's for the
Is
same
that bullying?
Reason.
It,
listen, it's the
Even Syria.
It's the same
against
reason.
Against all expectations.
It's the same reason, right, that if they pass this new resolution, which seems a lot more unlikely considering that France and Germany are completely saying there's no need for it. If they pass the new resolution, it will be for the same reason they passed the first one, because they are afraid of extinction. And to me, that is bullying.
What kind of Prime Minister do you want?
I don't want
a man who leads on his convictions.
I want somebody who leads on his convictions until the point that they're public.
Until the point that you disagree with
them. No, until the point that 90% of the public disagrees with them.
Well, that's the hard time. That's what he's paid for, isn't it?
Take hard decisions, not to be a populist. You're not paid to put people's lives in danger and ignore their opinion on that very subject. No one is paid to do that. You're not paid to put people's lives in danger and ignore their opinion on that very subject. No one is paid to do that. I have no sympathy with Saddam Hussein. I have no sympathy with him. He should be gone. We need him gone in order to stabilize the region. But you cannot do this at the moment when the entire fundamentalist terrorist network around the world is waiting for this to legitimize what they want to do.
How do you think you've contributed to the debate over Iraq?
Well,
I mean, if you take Shoot the Dog.
All goes on, don't shoot the dog, don't shoot the dog. So, sure, my dear, could you leave the way clear for sex tonight? Tell me, Tony, 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 I know that you're homie, but there's something about that bush in your brain.
You wanted a serious debate. How does that
you
kind
not,
of thing
I'll
contribute
what,
to a serious
what, that's
debate?
That's what I'm here for now. 8-9 months ago, no one wanted, and believe me, we're talking about a generation which has so little desire for politics in its music, that I knew that if I was going to be ahead of the game and try and get people to discuss this, I had to do it with some humour. And sure enough, even the humour, at that stage in time, it was something people did not want to hear about. Now that they're deluged with it, it's okay. I can come out here and I'm relatively safe. At that point in time, I wanted to write it, make the statements as broadly and as funnily as I could in the video to make sure that before people were too freaked out to talk, they laughed their way into things.
But things like, so Cherie, my dear, could you leave the way clear for sex tonight? Tony, 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 I know that you're horny, but there's something about that bush that ain't right.
Well, tell me what you're...
What does that contribute?
Okay, I'll tell you what it... Okay, can I read my own lyrics for a second? Excuse me. I'll tell you what it contributes. The idea...
Right at the top.
The idea is not anything to do... Now, Americans turned this into that they were having a homosexual affair, because, of course, that's kind of a joke that was in the video,
mm-hmm.
right? But actually, what it means is, Tony, 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 the idea is that she's saying she's going to withhold sex because there's something about that bush ain't right. Do you get the little joke in there? Bush. American
but
term for bush.
But what does it contribute to the debate?
It was to bring it to people's... And do you not think by any chance, because you're still not giving me any break here, do you not think... I don't know how closely you were watching popular culture at that time, but I think I dragged that argument into the mainstream, out of the political chattering classes, or whatever you would call them. I dragged that out of the political classes into the mainstream 2 or 3 weeks before it was going to get there. And I would say, at this point in time, when we're supposedly in such a bloody rush, that those 2-3 weeks were actually, it was worth what I put up with, it was worth losing the record, no one playing the record, no one playing the video. It was worth it because when I was attacked for doing it, it came into the mainstream. And that's exactly why I'm here again today.
People
exactly.
say it's an easy subject, anti-war protests.
I don't think this is an easy subject. It's not an anti-war.
Plenty of precedents for that. Anti-war, anti-this war in particular.
Oh, wait, sorry, what were the precedents for this in entertainment?
Plenty of people in the past.
Who talked before me?
About this particular... I'm not talking about this particular war. In previous wars.
So what was the thing that I was contributing when I first talked about this?
You tell me.
I brought it into the mainstream because I'm a pop singer, and there's almost no way of bringing politics into the mainstream these days unless you're not a politician. So I'm absolutely convinced that I was one of the first people screaming that we needed to have this chat, and that brought it forward. I'm very convinced that the actual date that they wanted the debate to start was September the 11th. I saw that the speech that Bush made from Capitol Hill on the night of September the 11th when nothing had gone off and everyone was thanking God that nothing had gone off. And I saw that speech and it made me absolutely aware. I couldn't understand around the time of the World Cup and the Jubilee why no one was talking about this.
You've taken a lot of criticism, as you say. You've walked into danger.
And I'll take a lot more.
Noel Gallagher says, George is now trying to make social comment. This is the guy who hid who he actually was from the public for 20 years. Now, all of a sudden, he's going to say something about the world. I find it laughable. That's before you get to the song, which is diabolical.
I think that's a laughable statement. What, the fact that I did not want to share my sexuality with the world in this current media... atmosphere. The fact that I didn't want to share my sexuality with the world means that I have no right to talk about politics. This is not an intelligent man. He's not someone you should throw quotes at me from, really. If you're going to find criticism, find it from Mr. Murdoch. You know, Mr. Murdoch attacked me solidly on Sky News, in the New York Post, and in the Sun. And what he would do would be he would print these slurs in the New York Post in such a way that when they reprinted them in the Sun, its sister newspaper, I could only sue on the basis of it being reprinted from the American source. And the American source would have been much harder to sue. So there was a campaign...
What worries you about the New York Post?
Well, what shouldn't worry me about the New York Post? It's a fascist newspaper.
A washed-up pervert.
Well, that would... Why should I worry about that? Apart from the fact... I mean, really, it's no... Why would I worry about that? I don't worry about the Daily Star. I don't worry about the Daily... You know, the Sport. I don't worry about the Sun or the Mirror. Why would I worry about that? I do find it absolutely unbelievable that they're able to call a homosexual man a pervert for having been caught cruising. I do find that quite laughable, but that is not suable.
But absolutely. People are saying, now that you're speaking about on this issue, why not about others? Why not against drugs? Why
because
not against
my family is not
sex?
At risk.
That would sit up and make people take
no,
it, just
okay,
wouldn't
and,
it?
Yeah, well, why would it? Those are the kind
because
of things
it would
that
be
rock
unexpected.
Stars thought. No, it wouldn't. Well, it would be unexpected for me to do just say no. Excuse me?
Have you done
you do
it?
A lot
Have you done it?
Of course not, because I've taken drugs. I'm not a hypocrite. Do you know, I'm not going to do that kind of rubbish. I'm not going to do that kind of thing. This is something that threatens the lives and the lifestyle of myself and the people I love. This is a lot more important than trying to discourage people from taking drugs or telling them that they really should pay for their CDs.
You think so? On a long-term basis?
What, this
yes.
altercation?
Yeah.
Well, I'm afraid I really do. And I think if you don't, then I'm jealous because you must be sleeping a lot better than me.
What do you want Saddam to do? What should be done with Saddam? If he doesn't, he's made it clear now, he isn't going to disarm, he won't get rid of the missiles.
I think I've already made
that
point.
Just talk to him?
No, not to Saddam. Saddam has to be dealt with in the way that Saddam has to be dealt with, but not now. Not until there's some effort shown in Palestine. Otherwise,
why are you linking the two together?
Because they're not linked, but every terrorist in the world who is an Islamic fundamentalist terrorist links those two things. Would you agree with that?
A lot do.
A lot.
But that doesn't make it right, does it?
Of course it doesn't, but this is not about right and wrong. This is what's dangerous about this situation. What this is about is the Pandora's box that was opened by the Americans, you know, in the 50s or 60s with the invention of the atomic bomb. That Pandora's box was opened then, and little bits from it are now internationally placed.
Make
right?
you feel better if the UN had a second resolution authorizing force?
Slightly, but I don't think, because I think that most of the people who have voted against Mr. Blair on this issue are not voting really on the issue of whether it's right for us to kill innocent people in Iraq, right? I don't really think they're voting on that. I think they're voting on that as normal, but this time they're saying, we do not want this war in our backyard. We did not do anything to deserve it. Our administration, as far as we know, did not really do anything to deserve it. I do not think Americans have the same point of view. I think that they have been attacked, they feel frightened, they understandably want a strong leader, they're not anywhere near as informed by their media as we are, and I honestly think that the majority of British people have no idea what we're doing here, on our own, with the Americans.